So we can actually work out what the VC dimension of a finite H is. And in fact, it's easier to just think about it in terms of an upper bound. So let's imagine that the VC dimension of H is some number D. And the thing to realize from that is that that implies that there has to be at least 2 to the D distinct concepts. Why is that? It's because each of the 2 to the D different labelings is going to be captured by a distinct hypothesis in the class, because we can't use the same hypothesis to get 2 different labelings. So that means that that 2 to the D is going to be less than or equal to the number of hypotheses. It could be that there's more, but there can't be any fewer, otherwise we wouldn't be able to get things shattered. So just, you know, simple manipulation here gives us that D is less than or equal to the log base 2 of H. So there is this logarithmic relationship between the size of a finite hypothesis class and the VC dimension of it. And again, and that's what we were seeing in the other direction as well, that the log of the size of the hypothesis space was kind of playing the role of the VC dimension in the bound.
Okay, that makes sense. And from that, it's pretty easy to see how 13 got in there.
Yes, it should be pretty much obvious to even the most casual observer of 13.
Yes, I think that's right. So I don't think there's any reason for us to explain it.
Yeah, I think one would have to really go back and look at the proof to get the details of why it has the form that it has, but or at least the details of the form. The overall structure of the form, I think we understand. It's just that the details come out of the proof, and we're not going to go through the proof.
And I think that's probably best for everyone.
So what we're seeing at the moment is that a finite hypothesis class or a finite VC dimension give us finite bounds and therefore make things pack learnable. What's kind of amazing, though, is that there's a general theorem that says, in general, if H is pack learnable if and only if the VC dimension is finite. So that means that we know that anything that has finite VC dimension is learnable from the previous bound, but we're saying that it's actually the other way as well, that if something is learnable, it has finite VC dimension. Or to say it another way, if it has infinite VC dimension, you can't learn it. VC dimension captures in one quantity the notion of pack learnability, which is really beautiful.
Yeah, I agree. That V and that C guy, they're pretty smart.